name is Pinocchio. I wasn't always a little boy. Once I was a puppet. You see, I wasn't born like other little boys. I was carved out of wood by a woodcutter. The man who carved me became my dad. As a wooden puppet, I could look around, talk, sing, laugh, dance, walk, and jump. My dad's house had only one room. Right away, I got into mischief. I not only walked around the room a lot, I ran away. I didn't care what my dad thought. The neighbors complained so much that my dad was taken away by the police for questioning. Alone at the house, I wondered what to do. I was getting hungry. There was this talking cricket that told me I was a bad boy and I deserved to be punished. I got so mad, I got a hammer and threw it at him. I guess it killed him. Then I tried to cook an egg, and a little chicken flew out of the shell and flew away. Dad was still not home, and I was getting hungrier. So I walked in the town looking for food, but it was terrible. There was rain, thunder, and lightning, and no one would help me. So I found my way back home still hungry. Then I tried to sleep and propped up my wooden feet on the hot stove. When I woke up, I had no feet. When Dad finally came home, he was very good to me. He forgave me and gave me food. Then he made me 2 new wooden feet. I promised that I would be a good boy and never run away again. I promised I'd go to school and learn a trade like other real little boys. Dad was pleased and he made me some school clothes and got me a school book. But when I was on the way to school, I forgot my promise and instead went off again. I wanted to see the puppet theater in town. The other puppets were like me. They were fun and we all seemed like family. But then I fell into the hands of assassins. The trip was so long, we spent the night at the Red Lobster Inn and planned to leave during the night. But while I was asleep, The fox and the cat left early and hid out on the road in disguises. When I came along the road, they tried to rob me. With those masks on, I didn't recognize them. They wanted my money, but I had hidden the gold pieces in my mouth, and they couldn't force me to open my mouth. I ran away as fast as possible, but they still caught me and hung me in a tree until I would do what they said. I hung in the tree for a long time. Then a beautiful spirit lady with blue hair helped rescue me. She had a falcon come and cut me down. I was really sick, so she had a bearded dog take me to her house in a coach pulled by 100 pairs of white mice. At her house, she sent for three doctors, a crow, an owl, and that talking cricket I thought was dead. The spirit lady was so nice, I wish she were my real mother. And that I was a real little boy. Later I cried because I missed my dad. When the spirit lady asked me about the gold coins, I lied about what I did with them. And you know what? My nose grew longer. I told a couple more lies, and it grew even longer. My nose got so long that it had to be trimmed. I guess I had to stop lying and be good so that I could someday be a real little boy and not a puppet. The spirit lady let me go look for my dad because I knew he was worried. Then again I met the fox and the cat, but this time they weren't disguised. They talked me into following them to a place called the Field of Wonders and planting my money into the ground to see it grow. But when I wasn't looking, they stole my money from the ground and I got put in jail for being so foolish. After I managed to escape from jail and that place, I walked along a long road and was stopped by this big snake right in the road. Getting past that thing was tricky. I tried to get back to the spirit lady's house, but I couldn't find it. I cried because I missed my dad and that nice lady. And again, I was getting hungry.
Thank you.
saw a bunch of grapes on a vine, stole them, and ate them. But just then, my foot got stuck in a trap. Then the farmer who owned the grapevine discovered me, got mad, and took me to his house to work off what I had stolen. I had to wear a dog's collar and be a watchdog for his hen coop. Later, when I helped him catch the thieves who were stealing from him, I was set free. On the road, I continued searching for the house of the spirit lady. When I couldn't find it, I cried. Then a big dove flew over and told me to stop crying. The big dove then landed and told me that she had seen my dad 1,000 miles away at seashore. She even let me fly on her back so I could find him. It was a long, scary flight. Seashore, I was determined to find my dad at sea. And because I was made of wood, I could swim easily. So I swam to an island, but my dad wasn't there. Instead, the spirit lady appeared again, gave me food, and talked me into going to school to learn what real little boys learn. That lady was so nice that once again, I wish she were my real mother and that I was a real little boy. I was tired of being a puppet, so I decided to go to school. But I had trouble with the schoolboys who made fun of me because I was a puppet. We got into fights, but I always came out okay. I could even run faster. Then I met a school friend who talked me into going to the land of playthings. Well, that turned out to be terrible. All the little boys who went there were turned into hard-working donkeys. But at first, I didn't know that. After a while, even I was turned into a donkey with long ears. Can you imagine how creepy that was? Believe me, it was hard to escape from that ugly place, but I did. An ugly old fisherman and a mean dog helped me so I could continue looking for my father. I continued swimming. Since my father's boat was far out in the sea, a good dolphin helped me to move through the water fast. But then, all of a sudden, we were both swallowed by a whale. That was really scary because it was dark inside that big whale. But you know what? I looked around in there and found my dad. It seems he and his little boat had been swallowed whole sometime earlier. We cried happy tears and hugged very much. Once again, the dolphin helped by showing us how to sneak out of the sleeping whale. Dad and I were very happy because we were free at last and we had found one another. big surprise was when the spirit lady magically reappeared and transformed me into what you see now, a real live boy.